वेलकम टू बैक. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन सिस्टम बाय द जे स्मिथ ऑफ द टेडोफाइट. ओके, वी कैन सी द डिस्टिंग्विश कैरेक्टर ऑफ द डिफरेंट डिविजन्स. नाउ वी आर एक्चुअली स्टार्ट स्टडी ऑफ द रिक्सी स्टडी ऑफ द सिलाजेना. दिस इज द स्पेसीज ऑफ द टेडोफाइट. नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी सी द देयर ऑकरेंस, देयर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, हैबिट एंड हैबिटेट. ओके, दिस आर द बेसिक कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ द एनी स्पेसीज. First is the occurrence of the pteridophyte. Okay, where pteridophyte is occurred? The genus Silagenella. Okay, study of the Silagenella. In now we see that the genus Silagenella is commonly called as the spike moss or club moss. This is commonly known as the spike moss or club moss. This is look like the spike cut mahit asel tumhala. Ja pramane spike asa cut asto. किंवा क्लब मॉस सारखा हा दिसतो म्हणून ह्याला काय म्हणतात, दिस इज अ कॉमनली नोन ॲज द स्पाइक मॉस ऑर क्लब मॉस. दिस विल बी द आस्क फ्रॉम द युनिव्हर्सिटी एक्झाम. ओके, दिस एमसीक्यू. द जीनस सिलाजेनेला इज कॉमनली नोन ॲज डॅश डॅश ऑर डॅश डॅश मॉस. काय म्हणतात, स्पाइक मॉस ऑर क्लब मॉस. हे दोन्ही शब्द लक्षात ठेवा, एमसीक्यूला तुम्हाला विद्यापीठाच्या विचारले जातील. देन नेक्स्ट इज द दीज क्लब माउस लक्झुरियली ग्रो इन मॉइस्ट शेडी प्लेसेस ऑर इवन एक्सपोज्ड ऑन रॉक सर्फेस. दिस सिलाजेनेला इज मोस्टली ग्रोविंग ऑन द मॉइस्ट शेडी प्लेसेस वेर मॉइस्चर इज अ प्लेंटी अवेलेबल. ओके, अँड शेडी प्लेसेस वेर इज ॲक्च्युली शेडी प्लेसेस देर इज अ लार्ज फॉरेस्ट. ओके, अँड हॅविंग शेड, हॅविंग अ मॉइस्चर ऑर इवन दे आर एक्सपोज्ड ऑन द रॉक सर्फेस ॲज वेल ॲज दे आर ग्रो ऑन द रॉक सर्फेस. फर्स्ट इज द इम्पॉर्टंट कॅरेक्टर्स रिगार्डिंग टू देअर ऑकरन्स, दॅट इज द सिलाजेना इज कॉमनली नोड ॲज द स्पाइक मॉस ऑर क्लब मॉस. सेकंड पॉईंट इज द दीज आर लक्झुरियली ग्रोथ ऑन द मॉइस्ट शेडी प्लेसेस ऑर इवन ऑन एक्सपोज्ड रॉक सर्फेस. द नेक्स्ट कॅरेक्टर, द स्पेसीज आर डिस्ट्रीब्युटेड इन बोथ ट्रॉपिकल टेम्परेट रिजन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. ॲज यू सी द होल वर्ल्ड इज डिवायडेड इन टू टू पार्ट, दॅट इज अ ट्रॉपिकल रिजन, टेम्परेट रिजन अँड पोलार रिजन. दिस स्पेसीज सिलाजेनेला ओनली डिस्ट्रीब्युटेड बोथ इन दीज आर फाउंड इन द ट्रॉपिकल अँड टेम्परेट. दॅट्स मीन्स दीज आर फाउंड इन द इंडिया, ब्राझील, ओके, साऊथ आफ्रिका, चायना अँड दीज ऑल्सो फाउंड इन द इंग्लंड, स्वीडन. ओके, ऑल दीज कंट्री कम्स इन द टेम्परेट रिजन्स. नेक्स्ट पॉईंट, मोस्ट ऑफ दिस स्पेसीज इनहेबिट डॅम्प. दिस मोस्ट स्पेसीज इनहेबिट इन द डॅम्प वेअर वॉटर इज अ स्टोर्स अँड शेडी फॉरेस्ट वेअर फॉरेस्ट इज अ डेन्स दे गॅविंग मोर शेड्स ऑफ द ट्रॉपिक. बट सम्स आर झिरोफायटिक आउट ऑफ विच सम स्पेसीज ऑफ द सिलाजेनेला आर द झिरोफायटिक. ओके, सम स्पेसीज आर हॅविंग इनहेबिटी डॅम्प अँड शेडी फॉरेस्ट of the tropic, but some are the xerophytic species. Xerophytes means those plant species occur in the water stress conditions. Okay, valvanta ja species growth hota tya species na apan xerophytic plant bolto. Example yacha madhe baghitle tar Silagenella rupteris je ahe, this is known as the xerophytic species. Silagenella pilitera asel, Silagenella lepidophyta asel. This is known as the xerophytic Silagenella plant. दीज ऑल्सो ग्रोविंग ऑन द एक्सपोज्ड रॉक सर्फेस. दिस सिलाजेनेला स्पेस इज ऑल्सो ग्रोविंग ऑन द रॉक सर्फेस. सिलाजेनेला ओरेना. ओके, ही सिलाजेनेला ओरेना जी आहे ही लक्षात ठेवा नाव, इज अ एपिफायटिक स्पेसीज. एपिफायटिक स्पेसीज म्हणजे काय, दोज आर ग्रोविंग ऑन द प्लांट्स, अदर प्लांट्सवरती ग्रोविंग होतो म्हणून त्याला एपिफायटिक म्हटलं. दे आर हॅविंग हँगिंग रूट ओगे लाईक, देअर फॉर इट इज नोन ॲज द एपिफायटिक सिलाजेनेला ऑर्गेना. हे एम्सक्यूसाठी विचारलं जाईल. यू स्पेसीज ऑफ द सिलाजेनेला इज अ इपिफायटिक स्पेसीज ग्रोविंग ऑन द ट्री ट्रंक. दिस इज नो कुठली स्पेसीज आहे तर सिलाजेनेला ऑर्जेना. ओके, सिलाजेनेला ऑर्गेना इज अन इपिफायटिक स्पेसीज ग्रोविंग ऑन द ट्री ट्रंक. दे ऑकर ओव्हर वाईड रेंज ऑफ हॅबिटॅट. दे ऑकर ओव्हर अ वाईड रेंज ऑफ हॅबिटॅट. नेक्स्ट कॅरेक्टर्स, A few species are found in temperate region where they grow on moist and shady mountain sides. The species of the Silagenella found in temperate regions, they also found, you know that these are found in tropical region as well as the temperate region where they grow on moist, okay, they grow on moist and shady mountain sides. They are also growing on the moist places as well as the shady mountain side. Most species require abundant moisture and shades. Those species, these species require abundant moisture and shade for their luxuriant growth. They require the plenty amount of moisture, shades, while some grow in open and dry situations. Okay, they also grow in the open where is no shades available, as well as in the dry situation. That's we can see it is called as the xerostratic species, that is a Coelaginella rupteris. Okay, like species that grow in the open and dry situation, but most of these species are required moisture and shade. This point clear? The next point is the Coelaginella. Coelaginella is a large genus. This is the large genus containing about 700 species. 700 species of the Coelaginella are present in the world. Out of 70 species have been reported in India. In India, out of 770 species are found in the India. Those names are the Coelaginella crausiniana, Coelaginella megaphylla, Coelaginella monospora, Coelaginella audunica. Okay. The next point, the plant body, that is a spore. Now we can see the external morphological characters of this Coelaginella. First point is the plant body, that is how their sporophytic structure look like. Okay, this known as the plant body, it is known as the sporophyte. That is the external morphology of the sporophyte. We know that in the Coelaginella, plant body is divided into root, stem and leaves. That is known as the sporophyte is divided into root, stem and leaves. First is the plant body. Coelaginella is sporophytic plant body. We know that the meaning of the sporophytic plant body, because as you see the sporophytic plant body form the spores, and the sporophytic plant body is a dominant, and in the pteridophytic gametophytic plant body is a short lived. Okay, and this sporophytic plant body is a dominant. Therefore, the sporophytic plant body is divided into root, stem and leaves. This sporophyte is differentiated into root, stem and leaves. Second point, the plant body is nearly flat. As you see the morphological structure, the plant body is nearly flat. This is a flat type and creeping. म्हणजे काय घसर जसं आपण सरपटत म्हणतो जसं गवत वाढतं तसंच द प्लांट बॉडी इज नियरली फ्लॅट अँड क्रिपिंग दॅट इज अ सिलाजेनेला क्राउसिनिया ऑर सब इरेक्ट ऑर दे हॅविंग सब लाईक देअर स्टेम and root are on the ground and their leaves are on the likewise. This is known as the upright erect with upright mouse like branches. Okay, this is having branches, sub erect with upright mouse like branches, that is a trichophylla. Some species are climber, some species of the pteridophyte are the climber, that is Coelaginella elegans. This will be the ask for the MCQ. Which species of the Coelaginella is the climber, that is Coelaginella algigans, and possessing special discoid pad on their rhizospore for climbing. They having the discoid pad for their climbing. Now here is the concept is the rhizophore. What is meant by the rhizospores? We know that the plant body is divided. This is a plant body, this is a stem, this is the leaves, okay, this is the root. Okay, they having extra branch like structure under the ground, and they possess this root like structure. This is known as the rhizophore. Okay, and this they are having a discoid pod on their rhizophore for the climbing. Then next point is the majority of the species are perennial. Majority of the species are the perennial, that means a short lived. Okay, they grow for 3 months or 4 months where water is available, where moisture is available. When dry condition is comes, their life cycle will be the end. Therefore, it is known as the perennial. Majority of the species are the perennial, but few delicate annular. But out of which, not all species are the perennial. Some species are the annual. That means they show their life cycle will for the whole year. Next is the in some xerophytic species, such as the Coelaginella lepidophyta, Coelaginella pilifera, are the entire plant during dry period assume a shape of tight ball, which in the presence of water opens into the normal green plants. Okay, here is some species of the Coelaginella, that is those are the xerophytic species such as the Coelaginella lepidophyta and Coelaginella pilifera. The entire plant during dry period, during the dry period when there is no water available, okay, that's mean the summer season, they assume a shape of tight ball. They give the their sporophytic gives the shape of the tight ball. Okay, they looking like a tight wall during the summer season, but when rainy season comes, water is available, moisture is available, this ball like structure get open into the normal green plant. Okay, and these are the known as the according to the change, they are according to change, they are the seasons. Next characters, such plant are commonly known as the resurrection plants. Okay, those plants during the summer season, they form the ball, tight wall like structure. When water is available, they get opened like a normal plant. Such plants is commonly known as a resurrection plant and are often sold as a novelties. This also are known as a novelties. These words, that is a resurrection plant, what is mean by the resurrection plants? For the MCQ, this MCQ will be the ask, okay, during your university exams. Okay, those plants which are during the summer season, during the dry season, those plants from the tight wall like structure, and when open, when water is available, this plants is known as the dash dash plants. Kali sal tyasathi this plants is known as the resurrection plant and are often sold as a novelties. Silagenella have been divided into two subgenera. The silagenella having two subgenera on the basis of sporophyte form or body. Okay, this having two subgenera. Okay, first is known as the homeophyllum. What is mean by the homeophyllum? What is mean by the heterophyllum? These are the two subgenera. First is the homeophyllum. Now, what is mean by the homeophyllum? In homeophyllum plant species, the plant body is upright. In this, we see that the plant body is the upright. Okay, erect. Okay, they are having the erect of like this. This is the plant body. This is the erect and upright with spirally arranged more or less uniform leaves. This having spirally arranged, okay, this having spirally arranged leaves. These leaves are isophyllous. This means they having the same size and spirally arranged. These leaves are the isophyllous and spirally arranged, okay, as well as the dichotomously branched stem. They having the dichotomously branched stem. This is the important characters for the homeophyllum. First is the plant body is the upright, okay, erect with spirally arranged more or less uniform leaves and dichotomously branched. These are the dichotomously branched stem. The leaves are isophyllous. The leaves are these homeophyllum having isophyllous leaves, and these leaves are the spirally arranged. These genera comprise more than 50 species. These genera comprise more than 50 species. Okay. Silagenella rupteri, Silagenella silaginoides, Silagenella pyamega. Okay, these are the species of the homeophyllum. Hejamadhe mahatvacha kay ahe homeophyllum madhe plant body hejamadhe kasha ahe erect ahe, upright ahe and spirally arranged ahe. Then is the heterophyllum, the member having prostrate and dorsi ventrally stems. आता ह्याच्यामध्ये इरेक्ट स्पेसिस होती होमोफायलम मध्ये. आता जर हेटरोफायलम मध्ये बघितलं, द मेंबर हॅविंग प्रोस्टेट अँड डॉर्सी वेंट्रली, प्रोस्टेट अँड डॉर्सी वेंट्रली स्टेम आहे विथ इरेक्ट ब्रांचेस. दे हॅविंग इरेक्ट ब्रांचेस, दे हॅविंग प्रोस्टेट अँड डॉर्सी वेंट्रली स्टेम, बट द ब्रांचेस आर द इरेक्ट. दीज आर द ब्रांचेस, दीज आर द इरेक्ट विच आर ऑलवेज इरेग्युलर. दीज ब्रांच आर इरेग्युलर. वन इज द लार्ज, one is a small, another is a large, another is a small, and they are the irregular in shape. Therefore, we will known as the member having this member heterophyllum member have prostate and dorsi ventrally stems with erect branches which are always irregular. The leaves show two dorsal rows. These leaves show leaves of the heterophyllum species show dorsal, two dorsal row. Varcha side la don row astil. Okay, this is the two row of small leaves and two dorsal row of large leaf, and these also having two row of large cell, large leaf. There are actually four row of the leaves, out of which two are the small and two are the large leaves. Okay, now we can see in this Silagenella. A is Silagenella, B is their habitat, foliar arrangement, and leaf with the ligules. Now we can see that here the root, stem and leaves. Sporophyte is divided into root, stems and leaves. From the stems, this is stem is the prostate. Okay, they showing erect branches. We can see there the erect branches, and on these branches these leaves are present. Okay, these leaves are present. Now we can see from the stems particularly branch, a special branches grow downward and from a root. This is known as the rhizophore. This branch is known as the rhizophore, okay, which grow under the ground and they form the root, which is known as the rhizospores. Okay, here we can see the strobilus where sporophyll compactly arranged, and then we can see that the this is a ventral leaves, this is a dorsal leaves. Okay, they having a different size. Ventral leaves are small, then dorsal leaves are very small and ventral leaves are the very large. Okay, when we see the structure of the leaves, midvein is present and at the small appendages at the base of this midvein, small appendage like structure, it is known as the ligules are present. These are the some morphological characters of the pteridophyte, that is the Scylla genella. Okay, in next lecture we see the anatomical characters. Okay, I hope this lecture will be the understand for you.